Hi everyone, welcome back to the Scriptcase Macros course. In this video, we're looking at the SC Ajax macro. So my name is Nate Carpenter, and I'm the instructor leading this. So let's go ahead and look at what this macro does. This macro is pretty simple. It displays a custom message from an Ajax event, but we have a lot of different settings and options we can do for this, and we're not even going to look at them all today. But we're going to look at some important ones to see how it works. So here's the documentation for it. So we've got a message here. The title, so that's the title of the message, and then parameters here, we'll look at what those are. And then we've got some parameters for redirection, and then here's some options for toast. So it's going to be you either have these parameters here, these two, or you have the toast parameters here. It's an either or situation. So as you can see, the message is the message itself, and then the title is going to be the title of the box. You can leave a blank. And then the message parameters are going to be formatted like that, kind of like a URL string. And we're going to see those down below. And then the redirection parameters, those are some settings you can set, some variables you can set if you're redirecting to another application, like so. This is just like the SC redir macro, if you've seen that video. And then the toast parameters are whether or not you want to display a toast message. We'll look at what that is, but you tell it to display a toast message, and then you have some types and some positioning that you can do for that. We'll look at how to do that in a second. So the message parameters, those options are down here in the second table here. So you can define whether or not it's a modal, whether or not it pops up over the screen, or it takes you to a different place. You can define whether there's a button, the label for that button, and then where it's going to display. So you can put a top margin, and then a left margin, and then the dimensions of the message, the width and height here. And that's all pixels again. And then you can define whether or not you're going to redirect. So you're going to put that redirect on the button, so you pass the application through. And then you can set those redirect parameters there, those variables if you need to pass them through. And so there's a target, blank or parent or whatever you want it to be. And then close, that's the X button up at the top of the modal. You can display that X. By default, it's no. And then the icon. So if you have some themes configured, there might be an icon in there that would be displayed. So you can turn that off or on, depending on what you want. So here's a couple examples down here. That you can see a basic one down below and then a toast one here. So we're actually going to copy this one and get started with this one. So I have a form set up over here. This is a pretty basic form. And I have a few fields, name, email, and then a password. And we're going to focus in on this password field here. And we're going to do some validation. Let me turn it on as a password field. So it redacts it. Let me hit save on that. And then we're going to set up some Ajax event. So I've got this Ajax event on password on blur. So that's when the user clicks out of that or tabs out of that field. And in here, we can do some validation here. So let's go ahead and run this before we start adding our code so you can see what this looks like. So it's just a basic form here, and there is our password field. So there's a length requirement on this for 8 characters. So we need to check if the password is 8 characters, and then we can display different messages based on whether that password length is met. So we're going to look at the string length of the password field. So we're going to use the curly braces here and our password field. So just type password there. That's going to get the value out of that password field right there. And then we just need to do the string length of that and make sure that it's over 8. So it needs to be 8 or more characters right there. So it's greater than or equal to 8. And if that's the case, then this is valid. So we're going to display just a little toast message that says the password is valid. So copying that code from the documentation. And we're not going to put a title on this. And let me make sure this string is formatted correctly. This is going to put it up at the top in the center. We'll see where that is in a second. And then the type is success, which is good since it is a successful condition. And then the message here is going to be password validated, or password valid, with an exclamation mark, like so. And so this should work. Let's go ahead and run this and see if we like how it looks. So we're going to go ahead and run this. And then we just need to type in a password that is 8 or more characters. So we wait for it to load here, and then I can type in a password here. So I'm going to make sure it's 8 or more characters, and we should see this message. Click out of it, and there it is. So it's over there. It looks nice, but it's probably not in a great position. We're going to put it up in the corner here. So to do that, we need to change the toast position. So we can go back here to the documentation and look at the toast position options here. So we're going to do it in the center, we're going to do it on the top, actually, top end. So that's going to put it over on the right on the top. So it's going to be right over there, which is where we want it. So top end is going to be on the right. The end means that it's on the right. The start would mean that it's on the left. I'm going to go ahead and run this now. Wait for it to load and then enter our password again. So waiting for it to load, enter our password, tab out of the field, and there we go. There it is up in the right with the check mark, password valid message. So that's a successful condition with a toast message. The next one is going to be just a regular modal message instead of a toast message. So this one, they need to click OK just to make sure that they actually see the message so they know what's going on. The toast message isn't absolutely critical that they see it. Since it's valid, that's OK. So this one is going to be password must be at least 8 characters long is going to be our message there. So that way they know that they need a longer password. And then we're going to get rid of this toast string here. And this is going to be our regular parameters, message parameters, which are documented down in this area. And the only one we're concerned about is a modal. We want to display a modal message. So we're just going to do modal equals y. And that should display our message. So there's a lot of different settings here that we could do with a timeout or button, etc. But we're not too worried about those. You can explore those on your own. They're pretty self-explanatory, but I'm just showing you some options for what you can do. So let's go ahead and run this and wait for it to load here. And now we need to enter a password that is fewer than 8 characters. So this is an invalid password that we're going to enter here. So I'm just going to click in the field here. And then I can type something in, so just 3 characters, and then click out. And there is our invalid password message, and then click OK. And they have to go back. So that way we make sure that the user actually sees the message and acknowledges it so that they know what to do to fix the issue. So that's how you use the SC Ajax message macro to display custom messages to your users.